day, fellow math learners! In this video lesson, we will be unlocking skills that particularly pertain to interpreting the mean and variance of probability distributions and applying the formulas to get the mean, variance, and standard deviation of a discrete random variable that we have learned from the past lessons. It would be best to clear your mind and breathe, so that we will have a meaningful understanding of today's topic. Let's start by recalling the formulas. Formula 1 is used to get the mean. Second and third are used to get the variance. And the third formula is used to obtain the standard deviation. Now, keep up with me as we try to guess the formulas for our first activity. You will attempt to answer which formula is to be used for certain situations that I will be flashing on the screen. Situation 1. I am thinking of finding the average number of heads that would appear if I will toss two coins together twice. Which formula should I use? If we analyze closely, we can find certain keywords that will guide us to find the answer. For this example, we have finding the average. You're getting what I mean, dear learners, right? Using this phrase, we know that the formula to be used is to get the mean. Therefore, Formula 1 is the correct answer. Next, Situation 2. I went to the grocery store and I noticed that there are 5 different kinds of brown sugar at different prices. Each brand has different probabilities that they will be sold. What formula should I use if I want to determine how the prices vary from the average price of the product that would be sold to the customers repeatedly? The answer is Formula 4, which is for standard deviation, using the keywords how the prices vary from the average price. Why? Although formulas 2 and 3 are used to measure the variability, in repeated trials, the standard deviation matches the assumed values of X, which are the prices of the brown sugar. I need you to prepare your interpreting skills as we move on to the main point of our discussion. We have here Activity 2 entitled An Unfair Die. Suppose an unfair die is rolled and let X be the random variable representing the number of dots that would appear with the probability distribution below. The outcome consists of the 6 faces of the die, which are numbers 1 to 6, and their given probability that is within 0 to 1 and has the summation which is equal to 1, according to the properties of a discrete probability distribution. Number 1. What will be the average number of dots that would appear? We will be using the formula to get the mean. Just multiply the value of the random variable to their corresponding probability and their summation, which is equal to 3.7. Now, we can interpret it as the mean of the probability distribution is 3.7. Since the mean is equal to 3.7, we can say that the average number of dots that would appear is a number near to 3.7, which is 4. Number 2. How does the assumed value of the outcome vary from the average number of dots that would appear? Using the formula of the variance, where we have to square the product of the value of the random variable and the corresponding probability, get the summation, and then subtract it to the square of the mean, we will get an answer of 1.81. And then from this value, we can get the standard deviation by getting the square root of the variance. Square root of 1.81 is equal to 1.35. Therefore, The variance of the random variable x, which is the number of dots appeared, is equal to 1.81, while the standard deviation is equal to 1.35. Now, dear fellow math learners, I have an interesting question for you to ponder. Will you join in a game of chance using an unfair die? We have good news! This video lesson is almost nearing its end, but before that, let's go for more examples. All you have to do is analyze the following pairs of data and identify which of the following will most likely yield to a higher variance and higher standard deviation. Put a check mark on the appropriate box. You can pause this on this queue as I will be revealing the answers in the next second. Before ending this, do take note of the following. Small variance or standard deviation means that the assumed values or data points tend to be very close to the mean. Higher variance or standard deviation means that the assumed values or data points are spread out from the mean. The variance and standard deviation measures or describes how far a set of data is spread out. The mean, variance, and standard deviation are important in statistics because they serve as the basis for other types of statistical calculations or statistical tests. Thank you for your time, dearest learners of the TON. Have a mathfulous day!